Hey, you guys, and welcome back to my channel. We are filming in a new little area here today, and that's because I just put up my Christmas decorations and I just wanted to kind of showcase them. You can't really see a ton right now, but I just enjoy being in here because it's just so festive. Anyway, if you are new to my channel, thank you so much for clicking this video. I would love it if you would subscribe. I make basically pregnancy updates, and I documented our journey to conceive because we ended up needing IVF. So I talked a lot about infertility on my channel and have been sort of trying to support the infertility community as well as document my pregnancy. I am 15 weeks along and feeling good and excited for our baby to join us in May. So if you would like to follow along, go ahead and subscribe. I would love to have you as part of this YouTube family. So as you saw from the title, this is going to be 25 things about me. I was just thinking this would be kind of a fun video to film to help you guys get to know me a little bit better. But I would like to get to know you better as well. So if you would put at least one or two things in the comments below that are unique to you, you know, they can be similar to something that I mentioned, but your answer, or whatever you want to put. I would love to get to know you guys a little bit more. You guys are so awesome and you make really sweet comments on all my videos, and I really appreciate it. But I would like to learn a little bit about you as well. So type something down below as you go along with this video that's a way that's like unique or just a way for me to get to know you better. All right, let's get into it. So first thing I wrote down was I practice yoga every single day, and that I don't practice like extensively. I just practice for about 15 minutes. Sometimes I do 30 minutes, and then sometimes I go to like a studio or the gym and practice for, you know, an hour or however long the class is. Second thing on my list is I hate Rice Krispie treats. And I really don't like using the word hate, but in this situation, I hate Rice Krispie treats. I'm going to tell you that I would not eat a Rice Krispie treat if I was super, super hungry. You cannot get me to eat them. I don't know what it is. I just don't like the combination of marshmallows with cereal, and yeah, I'm just not a fan. I used to think that I hated chocolate, and I would always tell people that I hated chocolate. Like, I didn't like chocolate. I didn't like to eat it. But when I got a little older, I tried like good dark chocolate, and I realized, wow, I really like this kind of chocolate. So I love dark chocolate. I'm not a fan of milk chocolate. I am super quick to say sorry. I'm always the first one to say sorry in basically any relationship. It's not hard for me to say sorry. I can admit when I've done something wrong. That's not my problem. But my problem is if I think I'm right, or like I know I'm right, I just know I'm right, then I will hunt down evidence to back up like my argument and why I think I'm right, and I will be the one to say, told you so, like I was right, which I know can be really annoying. I have three brothers and three sisters, and we are all very, very close. We do like sibling date nights, we hang out with each other all the time, we our best friends. I love getting into a hot car, like a really hot car in the middle of summer. I think it's mainly because my office and my house are always really cold, and so when I get into a warm, like hot car that's been sitting out in the sun, I just like bask in the warmth. And I think it bugs some people that ride with me because they're always like, oh, can we turn on the AC? Gosh, like it's so hot in here. And I always just forget because I just love sitting in a hot car. Not forever, like after 10 minutes or so, I'll turn the AC on. But I just love that like initial like warmth of a nice warm car that's been sitting in the sun. So if I have to drive or travel somewhere that I'm not familiar with, I've never been to or whatever, I don't know, like have the directions to get to that place, then I will research and study a map like extensively before having Siri or Google Maps tell me how to get to a place. I do not like having a robot to tell me how to get somewhere, even though I know it's super helpful and I do use it occasionally, but I would rather just like research a map and know exactly where I'm going without having somebody or something tell me how to get there. I am not really into astrology, but I am a Virgo. I am a red-yellow personality, and Eric is as well. So I'm not sure if you're familiar with the color code test or book. Actually, I think it's called the People Code book. But anyway, I took that years and years ago, and I've taken it a couple times since then, and I always get red-yellow as my personality. So if you're not familiar with it, red is kind of like motivated by power. They're always like kind of the leaders, or they're usually pretty organized and stuff like that. And then yellow is like they're motivated by fun and like play. So I am basically half red, half yellow. So I like to work, 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 and like get the job done and then play. I really love to play. And Eric is basically the same. He has a little bit of blue in him as well, but we're basically both red, yellow, half and half. I graduated with a bachelor's in exercise science in 2011, but I currently work in marketing. I wanted to be a physical therapist when I was in college, but then when I started doing some shadowing and started kind of dipping my toes into what that actually would entail as a career, I changed my mind. I danced for most of my life. I even danced in college, all through college. I almost majored in dance. Ballet specifically was my favorite. I am half Mexican, but I don't speak any Spanish. So one of my pet peeves is when people say, "I don't have time for this or that," or whatever it is. Like, especially exercise, people will say, "I don't have time to exercise." It's not about having time. We all have the same amount of time. It's just what we prioritize our time for. So I wish people would say something more like, "I don't prioritize my time for exercise," or whatever it is. I don't know why that bothers me, but it just does. I do not like to park right. So I don't know if this makes sense, but whenever I'm driving my car and I'm going to park, I will park further out if that means I can turn like left to park. I just feel more comfortable like turning my car left into a parking spot than I do turning right. It's just a weird thing with me, I guess. I like to say that I have 13 sisters because I'm very, very close to my cousins, and there's about four, well, including me, there's 14 girls on my dad's side. So, and we grew up together, we're all the same ages. We're very, very close. So I like to tell people I have 13 sisters. I will only chew gum for 15 to 30 minutes max. Like after that, it grosses me out. I'll eat food that falls on the floor for longer than 3 to 10 seconds. I am not a germaphobe at all. I don't really like potatoes. I'm super, super picky with potatoes. They have to be like potato chips or a certain type of fry, like a McDonald's fry, or I don't know, really crispy, good, salty fries. I don't like thick fries. I don't like In-N-Out fries. They're really cardboardy. I am very picky with potatoes. I've struggled my whole life with anxiety, and I didn't really realize what it was until I was in college and my parents were getting divorced. It was, a lot of stress. So I struggled with that basically my whole life, but it was especially hard when I was struggling with infertility as well. I loved going to school growing up. I l was very social, I still am, and I just loved the routine of waking up early, going to school, going to each class, and I just loved my teachers and friends. And when summer break would come around, I would basically cry because I was so depressed that I had to wait 2 or 3 months to go back to school. I was like this until I got into high school, and then it wasn't a big deal because I would still see my friends through the summer, and I got really involved with like work and like dance and stuff through the summer. So I wouldn't cry when I couldn't go to school in the summer once I was about like 14 or 15. I love room service. I don't order it all the time, obviously, because it's so overpriced, but it's just like such a thrill for me to get room service. And it doesn't even matter if the food is that good. I just love having someone bring you food right to your bed, basically. I live in Utah and I love it. I don't really want to live anywhere else, at least not right now. But if there was another state I could live in, I would probably choose Texas or somewhere in the South. I really love Texas. I've been there a bunch and I don't know. I just love all the southern states and would probably pick any one of them to live in if I wasn't living in Utah. The last one I have on my list of 25 things about me is Beyonce and I share the same birthday, and that is September 4th. She's a little bit older than me. I don't know, a few years older than me, but we were both born on September 4th. And that is it for this video, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to comment below so I can get to know you a little bit better. And follow me on Instagram for more day-to-day updates. And I'll catch you in my next video. Bye!